inside, get what we need.
And this is this week's Closet Classic.
Everybody?
Hi.
I'm Red.
I'm Caroline.
She's Caroline. And we're here on the Red Sox Show.
So welcome. So, Red.
Yes. Christmas? Ah, Christmas? Mm-hmm. Kind of white. It was a white Christmas. With a white wipe. Did you see that?
White Christmas?
Didn't you just see it? Well, it was, you know, it went by kind of quick.
Oh,
yeah. See, there it is. It just flashes before your eyes.
I guess I missed it.
Well, you gotta have big eyes, like me, see?
Stuck, I guess, where
I can hypnotize you. People at home, call. Call the show. And the number to call is... Peter Romagna. Put up the graphic. Peter.
Yeah, what's going on back there? Hey guys, what's going on back there? Let's see.
Oh, there we go.
There it is. It's live. 272. Wait a minute, the cup's in the way. I can't see the thing. 8746. December 28th only. So, if you call on December 29th, you're an idiot. You don't deserve to win if you call on the wrong day. It's part of the contest. The contest here is to answer questions and stuff. So, let's, how was your Christmas, other than the lack of snow?
It was good. It was a very busy Christmas, but it was good. Sweaters and an awful lot of gifts and presents.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
That's cool. What kind of sweaters? If you got sweaters for Christmas, call 272-8746. Oh, yeah. My Christmas was pretty good because I escaped being pinned to somebody's chimney and stuffed full of toys. Yes, I am. But I can pretend to be nice if you call. Anyways, speaking about a bunch of toys, let's show, we got prizes if you call in. Let's see, you can choose between, what do we got, Starbucks gift certificates. So you can get coffee. That's not Starbucks gift certificates. Pete's sake.
Fun.
Well, yeah.
I'm allergic to coffee. I can't have it. I don't want to.
Allergic to coffee?
They're in here somewhere. Here they are.
I love coffee.
There we go.
Coffee makes me the calm, cool individual I am. Okay. Let's go see them. They're over there. They're over. That's true. So, and also, if you don't like that, you could go for one of our random prizes in the Wacky Box.
Like Scooby-Doo.
That's right. Scooby-Doo could belong to you.
Or other cool stuff like that.
That's true. Where could you be without an etch a sketch pen? You'd be nowhere. You'd be lost.
Very interesting assortment of prizes. So,
yes?
Peter should be joining us.
Oh, yeah, they are pizza races.
Well,
first let's introduce our crew. Hey, director, go to that other camera we got in now. Hey, there's our crew.
Hi, crew.
And they're all hiding behind the graphic. Yo, there we go. Good job, Pete. Okay, well, let's say hi, everybody.
Hi.
Okay, that's Peter.
Oh, all right.
And there's Billy.
What's Peter doing again? He should be coming out here.
Jesse's directing. And the top of Megan's head. There we go. Hi, Meg. So they're doing all the tech stuff.
Yeah.
And so, if you see, yeah, Peter, get out here.
Yeah, come on. Hey, what's going on with that pizza race?
What?
Shouldn't we be ready to roll
for
that?
Corey. Yes. What about him? What?
No pizza race.
No pizza race? Wait a minute.
That means no pizza?
So what are we going to do?
Corey? What are you doing? Hey, Earth to Corey.
Yo.
Corey.
Captain Bonehead.
Red and I would like to know what's up.
Gotta get this last piece in. You go do the show. I'll get it to you by the show or next show or something like that. Oh, come on, I'm busy. Hey.
I cannot believe it.
Hey, Peter.
What a slacker.
Go kick his butt.
Go get him, Peter.
Okay. But I think.
Hey.
What?
Who won the first race?
Well, Pup Gina's won the first race.
And who's the second round, people? Don't tell who won.
It was.
That's
a mystery.
Okay, so that'll be next month?
Yeah.
It better be.
But I think we may do it in advance so we know. So we can just do that. Oh,
okay.
Yeah, we want to.
Hey, you know what?
What?
You should get back to work now.
Yeah, okay. We need you out there.
Yeah. We'll put up some more graphics.
Have a good show.
Okay. Thanks for joining us, Peter. I am so disappointed.
Me too.
I was really looking forward to that.
Well, luckily it's going to be New Year's soon.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Oh!
You doing anything special for New Year's?
Oh, me?
Yeah. And doing anything special down there?
What did you like to know? I have more fun down here than I do up there.
I would rather not know anything about that.
Watch where you put the barbecue there. Oh, hey.
Okay. So, that was a fun show.
Thank you for calling. Thank all of our guests. So.
I'm declining my question about what you're doing for New Year's.
Oh, who, me?
I'm probably just hanging out with a few friends.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, it's not one of those fun New Year's where everyone thinks the world's going to blow up. It's just on a O2, you know?
What? The world didn't blow up?
Yeah, there's usually some crazy people that always think, something terrible's going to happen on New Year's. And
well, you know, eventually, one of these days, they might be right. If you keep saying it every year.
Yeah, someone will make it happen.
Yeah.
Terrorist attack from aliens or something.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Which kind of aliens? Like Elf or the ones from the movie?
I have no idea.
I'd rather be killed by the ones from the movie because, at least they're scary. If we were taken over by the elf aliens, I would just want to bury my head in the sand.
That would be interesting.
That's true.
That would be rather degrading, actually.
Well, wait a minute. I got to go check the barbecue. I'll be right back.
What is... I don't want to know. I just don't want to know. So anyways...
Yes?
So, no pizza today. What a disappointment.
Well, actually, after all the eating we do on the holidays, that's probably a good idea.
Yeah, but I didn't have breakfast. I'm hungry.
You didn't have breakfast?
No. Well, I had to run out the door. I had to work at 8, you know?
Really? You had to work?
I had to work.
Ha!
Oh, be quiet.
I don't work. I'm independently wealthy.
Yeah.
I also like to take long walks by the lake. Wait a minute. This is not a kind of video.
Hey, camera guy. Sock doesn't cost very much to live. Like, he doesn't have a very high bill pile, like some of us. The rest of us have to work, so he just sits there and gloats. Gloats, gloats, gloats. I'm just kidding. I still like you.
Actually, it's true. It's a pretty low-maintenance lifestyle.
Yeah.
You know, so if you ever considered having, you know, being a sock, the surgery's expensive, though. If you don't start off as a sock, to have, like, the species change,
yeah, I suppose.
That costs a lot of money. You go down to, like, what is it, the Valley in California, a lot of plastic surgery. A lot of, well, not plastic, more wool. You gotta have wool surgery. Somewhat painful. I don't recommend it. If you're not a sock now, you should stay as you are, even if it's not as good as being a sock.
Yes, be proud of who you are.
Yes, and that's who I am.
Oh, we learned a lesson today.
Peter learned how to put up our names. You go, Pete.
All right.
That's what we like, on-the-job training.
Very good.
Where what? Wait a minute, I'm getting a cue from downstairs. I'll be right back.
Oh. He does that often, I guess, lately.
Okay. By the way, that's the number on the other side of this cop. Hold on a minute. 781-272-8746. That's the number to call. You can call on December 28th, and you can win a prize.
Sounds good.
So, I hope we sound okay. Hey, Meg, do we sound okay?
How's those mics?
Let's see Meg. Meg, where are you? There she is. How's the mics, Meg?
All right.
Super. How does everything else sound? Thanks,
Jess.
Jess.
Hey, Jinx.
Woo!
Anyways, anything else interesting happen on your Christmas?
On my Christmas?
Yeah.
Well, I had to call the police because there was this big chubby guy walking around on my roof.
How long have you had that problem?
I don't know. Him and his 8 little dogs.
Dogs?
Yeah, they were pulling his sleigh. They were weird-looking dogs with bones coming out of their head.
You don't think that was actually Santa Claus?
Nah, this guy was chubby.
He didn't try to, like, stuff you with toys?
Oh, yeah, that's him. I filed, like, assault, I think it was.
Yeah.
Assault on a sock is a very dangerous thing. You have to be kind to socks. Like fabric softener. Really nice. That's what we like.
Hey, sock. Sock.
Yes?
Santa Claus?
What about him?
Might be a little damaging, but he doesn't exist.
Hey, Santa doesn't exist?
Mm-hmm.
And you're talking to a sock.
Good point. All right,
let's continue.
Anyways.
So anyways, if you're out there, Santa, you didn't stuff me full of toys this year, so good job. And, let's see, what about, so New Year's, do you have any resolutions?
I don't know, I kind of like to get back in shape. You know, exercise every day kind of thing, maybe I'll work on once a week first.
Which kind of workout, do you want to be like, Lou Ferrigno muscles, or?
No. Just enough so that by the end of the day, I'm not as tired as I usually am.
No, like an energy thing.
Yeah.
Speaking about, like, energy things, are you going to get one of those, what are they called? It's. Those Segway things, like human mover, what are they?
I have no idea what you're talking about. Sorry.
It's some kind of, like, go-kart scooter thing with a motor and you drive around.
Oh, those scooters.
Yeah.
Like the Razors.
Yeah, but with a motor on them.
You know, they look like fun. But they're really expensive. I don't know if I'd want to spend the money for the little amount of time I'd actually use one.
$3,000?
Yeah, about.
Well, what would you rather do if you had $3,000? And don't think that's a prize on the show. We don't give out $3,000. We don't have $3,000.
No, I don't think we'd give it out if we
We do have a grand prize, though. It's a Red Sox gift certificate. And you could win that, but you have to do, like, a really hard question.
But...
La, la, la.
Yeah, I don't really spend my time on those kinds of things. Scooters and such. I prefer my car. Works a little better.
Oh, yeah. Also, when it rains, it's probably better, too.
Yeah. I have a roof over my head.
But can you imagine being pulled over by a police officer on one of those things?
I don't think it would happen. You can't really speed on those.
What could they catch you for? Like, not using your turn signal?
I don't think it'd actually go on the road. You know what I mean?
You mean those things are gonna go on the sidewalk?
Well, they're little. They're tiny.
Yeah, but they go like 20 miles an hour.
Oh, you mean the electric ones. See, I've been talking about the ones that you push with your foot.
Oh, those?
Yeah.
Well, for those of you that have feet.
Okay.
If I had a foot, it would be painful because it would be like sticking into my brain.
Well, Sock, you wouldn't be able to reach the handlebars anyway.
Yes, I could see. I can lift things.
You are very strong.
That's okay. What? Wait a minute. I got a report from the down. What's that, Jesse?
We're not recording.
Say it again.
We're not.
Well, why don't you start recording?
Nice show.
Put the control room on.
It's still my show.
Hey, Jet, put the control room on.
It's still sit down. Live.
Control
hey,
room.
Hey, guess what? We have a backup tape.
Do we?
Yes, we do.
Good.
That's interesting.
What are you guys saying? Hold on a minute. People talking down there. Yeah, there's a backup tape. Now, I want it well done. Don't set off the fire alarm. Oh. Hello. Woohoo! Hey, it's our first caller.
Oh, right.
That's one caller every two shows. We should get like six a year.
Yeah, there you go.
Hey, caller. What's your name?
Caller.
Caller.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
Gary.
Hey, Gary.
Hi.
What do you want to go for?
How are you?
I'm doing okay. Riding at the end of the year.
Oh, yeah.
See how it works out.
Yeah, I know.
What are you planning for the big 202? Or was it
2002?
Yeah.
Oh, a little fun, a little dance.
Oh, that's cool.
Through my pants, I don't know, something like that.
Hey, what a better way to spend a year.
There you go.
Got any New Year's resolutions you want to share with everybody?
No, I'm just going to try to be nicer to everybody next year.
Okay, cool.
That's a nice resolution. That should be everybody's New Year's resolution. Everyone
needs I probably couldn't keep it, so I won't do it.
I couldn't either, but you know, it's a nice thought.
Yeah,
anyway.
That's true. How many resolutions have you kept, do you think? What's the ratio?
Me?
Yeah, both of you.
Zero.
Zero.
Well, you know what? That doesn't really apply to me. I don't usually make New Year's resolutions.
I've had one that I've kept.
That way I never break them.
I made a New Year's resolution about 5 years ago to make no more New Year's resolutions, and I've kept that one pretty good.
There you go.
You've done a great job.
Okay, Gary, we got three prizes. You can go for Starbucks, you can go for something from the Wacky Box, or you can go for the grand prize, which is a little bit tougher.
Let's go with the grand prize.
Okay. The grand prize, name the capital of three New England states.
Capitals of three New England states?
Yeah.
Montpelier in Vermont.
Okay.
That's good.
We've got Augusta, Maine.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And Boston, Massachusetts.
Okay, judges?
There you go.
What do they say in the back room? This is the grand prize, you know. Back room, what do you think? Is that right? Okay. You got the grand prize.
All right.
Okay, great.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You have anybody you want to say hi to or anything you want to mention before you head out?
Can I say hi to Ryan?
Yeah, sure.
Hi, Ryan.
He's around here doing something.
Yeah, he'll hear you, definitely.
Okay.
Well, maybe he's downstairs. Hold on a second. Hey, Ryan!
Yeah?
Say hi to your dad.
Hey, Dad!
Oh, wait a minute. Your son's part of our crew. You're eliminated. That would be nepotism.
I'm sorry.
But, if you disown him, we can still give you the prize.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yep, have a good night.
Hey, Happy New Year.
Oh, Happy New Year to
Happy
you,
New Year.
Gary.
Thank you. Bye.
Well, there
that
you
was
go.
Nice.
Oh, hey. We got a PSA break.
All right.
All righty. Okay. Is the whirlpool ready? Okay, I'm going to go downstairs.
All right, I'll see you, Red.
Okay, have fun with the PSA break.
Bye. First thing I friggin' recorded.
Hey, come on.
Excuse me.
Your local library has all the information you need, and some you don't.
Still fixing whatever down there. We have another call? All right. Hi, caller.
Hello.
Hi. Who am I talking to?
Afia.
What's your name?
Afia.
How you doing?
Good. How are you?
What's going on?
We have another caller, Red.
We do?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow. I leave for like 1 minute and we get another caller.
We get another caller. We must be getting popular.
Hey, what's up?
Nothing much. You?
You know, we're just hanging out, chatting, talking about stuff.
That's cool.
Hey, keep him under control. I don't know what he's doing here. Oh, sorry. So, we have two types of prizes left. But before we get to the prizes, let's talk about you.
Oh, that sounds good.
So, how was your holidays?
It was good.
Any particular highlights you want to share?
What'd
you get?
I got a CD player, and I was looking forward to that.
Ooh, a That's CD good. Player? What kind of music do you like?
Pop.
Any particular bands or groups? Or
NSYNC.
Singers?
NSYNC.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever seen them live?
No, not yet.
Ah, okay.
But you plan to.
Yes.
My headroom. Anyways, so... Hey, spell your name for the graphics person.
A-F-U-A.
Got that?
A-S-U-A.
F-F.
F. Oh, A-F. I didn't think that made sense.
You gotta do like Army, Alpha, Franklin, Ulysses, Alpha. So, Afia.
Mm-hmm.
We have two types of prizes left.
Mm-hmm.
One is, what is it?
Oh,
oh, you're over there. I get lost.
One is our Starbucks gift certificates.
And you get like a thing from there?
Yep.
And probably don't like coffee.
The other one is something out of our, you know, out of our gifts in the grab bag.
That's the wacky box.
Wacky box. That's right.
I'll go for the wacky ball thing.
Okay.
All right.
You got a question?
No, I don't.
I gotta think now? Hold on a second.
I'm gonna make you think.
Ow! I think I hurt my brain.
Well, Red, it's a good thing you drank all of that.
Let me think of a question.
We'll get a refill down here.
Okay, let me think.
Yep, got that.
Do you know anything about sports in...
That's enough.
Do you know anything about the local sports team, Sophia?
Not really.
Oh, good. Then I've got a sports question for you. No. Let's see.
There we go.
What's the name of the university that Harry Potter goes to?
Hogwarts.
Alrighty.
Very good.
Okay.
So, what do I do? Just grab one?
Close your eyes and pick out something for Sophia.
Oh.
What you get?
Our studio guys are going to be disappointed. This is leaving. Yeah. Was that a cheer?
Okay, Afia?
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what BCAT is?
Yes.
Have you ever been to BCAT?
Yeah, yesterday.
Oh, well, that's convenient.
Oh, that's good.
So you're just going to come to BCAT and pick up your prize.
Okay.
And?
She gets our
self-inflating
whoopee cushion keychain. Is
what
BCAT I have
is
out.
Open from 10 to 10, Monday through Friday, and 10 to 4.
Saturday.
On Saturdays.
Yep.
Okay.
So, we'll...
Here we go.
So, we'll see you around, and you can pick up your prize.
Okay, thank you.
Oh, wait a minute.
Thank you.
Here we go. Got any New Year's resolutions?
To be better in math.
Do better at math?
That's a good one.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
I always wanted to be better in history. I broke that one right away, as soon as school started.
That's true.
Never meant to, but...
I was pretty good in school. Most, you know, I got like, what do you call it? Fs, because I was fine.
Right.
Fantastic.
Right.
On everything. Fabulous.
But
yeah.
When you're a sock, you never have to look for a job.
That's true. I was on the track team. 1 foot at a time.
Hmm.
Well,
okay.
Talk to you later, Afia.
Bye.
Bye. All right, so we've had two callers. So,
Yes? That's two callers more than we had last time.
Yeah, it certainly is.
Gee,
I tell you, we are getting popular.
Cool.
Is that, barking, I hear?
No, that's not barking.
I definitely hear something.
Okay. Well, maybe you should have, like, a psychiatrist check that out.
No, really, what's going on? Hey!
Ah! I told you guys to keep him down there! Get away from me!
I didn't know you... Where did you get them? Where did you get him? He is so cute. Oh, look at him. He's so cute. What's his name?
He doesn't have a name.
Yes, he does.
He's just a big shag.
Okay, shag.
Go home. Go someplace other than my house.
Oh, I want to see him. Oh,
yeah,
he's
stop
so
that
cute. What, did you get him for Christmas?
No.
Hey, you be nice to him. No. He's cute. You got him for Christmas, didn't you?
What? No, I didn't.
Who gave him to you?
Go home.
Red?
Go.
Red.
Give me your steak and go home.
I'll take your coffee.
What?
Who gave him to you?
He followed me.
Yeah, right.
Home from the bus terminal.
You're hiding something.
I'm not hiding anything. Where would
I
hide it?
You were around last Friday night. You weren't.
Who, me?
Who? Was it a female somebody?
No. No. Uh-uh.
All right.
Not
what
me.
Color is she?
Nope. Nobody. Cold
cotton. Come on.
Wait a minute. What's that say? Don't. I'm not denying anything. I'm not in denial.
You are completely.
I am not.
You have a girlfriend, and she gave you a dog for Christmas.
Ugh. Well, he gets. What kind of gift is that?
Corey, we need to know. You're his
best friend.
Don't
tell them anything.
You must know, Corey. Come on.
You should be editing, Corey. The pizza races. Come on.
He's never going to.
Who's next, Megan?
I don't know. He doesn't tell me anything. I'm busy. Go back to the show.
Oh, there's Ryan.
Ryan? Do you mind not running through the middle of our show?
Corey couldn't tell me anything. So,
Ryan, what are you running through our show for? Ryan, come over here.
Come on, no. Don't change the subject. I want to know. I want to know. What's the deal?
I was asking Ryan why he's running around during a live show.
Well, hi, Ryan.
Hi.
No, you can stand over there.
Yeah, speaking to Caroline. She's Mike.
So that you're in the camera. Yeah. Hi, Ryan.
How's your girlfriend?
What are you talking about?
See that? Everybody knows.
I'm not going to listen to him. He's got a shaved head in the middle of winter.
I've been hearing things.
Yeah.
Hey, guess what? You get to play mailman. You can bring the gift your dad won home.
Mm. Would you like to deliver that anytime soon?
Yeah.
Here you go. When you're done working.
There you go. That saves us a stamp, huh?
Yeah, it does.
That's how we think here.
And we're cheap, so... Oh, woo-hoo! Was that out loud? Okay, sorry.
Shh.
You said it.
Remember, thinking, the lips don't move.
Right. I forget so often. But anyways, so, any New Year's resolutions while we keep mentioning that?
No, not at all.
Not at all?
No.
That's the safe way to play it.
Yep.
It really is.
Can't break them that way.
That's it. Yeah, it's true. Red, I am definitely interrogating you later. Don't think you're out now. Are you getting dizzy yet?
Hey, where's
no,
that?
No, I'm thinking!
Where's that puppy? Doesn't
hear what I said like a minute ago?
Where's that
right.
Shag puppy? I want to see Shag.
I think he told him to go home.
He's guarding my house.
Shag went home? Why did
yeah.
He decide to go home?
Because he's guarding my house.
Because he doesn't want me to see his puppy that his girlfriend gave to him for Christmas.
What's her name?
What are you talking about?
Your girlfriend. We all know your girlfriend.
Oh, yeah? What's she look like?
We don't know. That's
what that's what we have to find out. Well, apparently,
so what you don't know,
Corey
you don't need to be told.
Either, so.
Yeah,
no, Corey
will
tell.
We have a PSA. I think we do.
We do have a PSA.
Hey, go to the control room. Hello? Guys, you there?
Keep here. Yeah, that's it. That's it. Yes! All right, good job. Walk it off. Walk it off.
Your local library has all the information you need, and some you don't.
Good job, buddy. You look good out there. How do you feel? You look good.
Whoa, that pig could run.
Oh, yeah.
7-minute mile. You think we should enter pigs into the Olympics?
That would be interesting.
Would they be part of the American team? Or would they have, like, their own, like, animal team? Like, Animal Farm?
They would definitely be, probably of their own. Yeah, definitely.
And you know what the best thing about a pig running is?
The squealing?
Other than that.
Okay.
4 legs, no socks. There's a lesson there.
Well, then what's to be said about dog racing?
They don't wear socks either.
That's right.
I don't even think that shag dog wears... Wait a minute.
Hey, is he still there? I thought you told him to go home.
What?
I thought you told Shag to go home.
Well, I can see my house from down there.
Oh.
So, yeah, see? No socks. You don't need socks. You shouldn't have to wear socks. They inhibit you. Your socks should just be placed, like, somewhere nice in the sun. Feed them.
Uh-huh.
Give them baths.
Uh-huh.
Don't go to the laundromat. They don't like that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's basically what you do with the socks.
That's right. Oh, my goodness.
Something going wrong. Somebody in the control room has, like, indigestion.
Or the control room itself is having indigestion. You never know
the
lights
hey, guys, the lights aren't in there yet?
Yeah, they had a little bit of blackout before.
Hey, we got a pretty good crew if they can do their job in the dark.
Hey, leave it up to Jesse.
Woohoo!
He's good.
And that's where we'll stop that conversation. What else has you been up to?
What else have I been up to?
Yeah.
Oh, just kind of going to school, dealing with my class. I had we did a trivia game today.
I'm in every shot. I'm in this shot. I'm in this shot. And I'm in this shot.
You're very good.
Narcissism, it's a wonderful thing. At least for me it is.
Yeah.
I don't know if it'll work for everybody else. So, anyways, you were saying?
I was saying. Yeah, I had a party for my kids today. They had, you know, no school, so I decided, you know, we got to make it a fun week, because when they have no school, I work from 8 to 6 instead of 10 to 6. So I go in extra time, and they come and have fun. We did parties. We went bowling yesterday.
You went bowling?
Yeah, they enjoyed that.
Where'd you go bowling?
Brunswick in Burlington.
Ah.
And it was fun. I bowled a strike. I was very happy about that. I haven't bowled in a long time, so I was very excited.
I went bowling once. It was like I kept crossing the line because I'm like trying to push the ball down and kept crossing the line. And do you know the worst thing about when I was bowling?
What's that?
They made me rent shoes. It's like some kind of requirement. I'm like,
you know, there's got to be an obvious restriction there.
But no, they made me. I'm like, I want to go bowling, and they're like, well, you have to have shoes. And I was like, hey, but I don't need shoes. And they're
I go in my socks.
Ow!
Well, hey!
Ow!
It doesn't bother them.
Probably they're stunned. They're probably unconscious or something.
Hey, all the cool sliding across the floor. You know, it's like skating. I think it's fun.
What if I slid you across the floor?
I've done that.
Oh, okay. Maybe it is fun.
Okay.
If you've been slid across the floor, give us a call, lad. Ah! I'm having a bad hair day.
That's all right. There you go.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm also his makeup girl.
Well, if I need someone to make up with, I'll let you know.
Right.
781 hey, juice.
The family show. That was Queen. Jesse's always yelling at me.
That was Father Murphy. Thank you, Father Murphy.
Father Godin.
272-8746.
Right there.
That's the number to call.
Yep.
And you could win a lovely prize.
From our lovely prize box. Our West
box. Exactly.
So. Oh, so, yes. I'm really hungry right now. Missing that pizza. The whole idea that it's not coming is just making me hungrier. Do you ever get that? Like, you're hungry and then you're not going to get fed, so you're hungrier automatically.
Oh, yeah, because there's, like, no end in sight.
Yeah. But I'm really hungry right now. Oh.
Well, Well, it's really bad is if you think you're going to get fed and you don't get fed.
Yeah, that's really bad. Yeah,
like the pizza doesn't arrive.
Ultimately, we have to yell at Corey.
That's true. Hey, wait a minute. The control room has a phone.
Yeah.
Hey, control room, why don't you order us a pizza?
Good idea.
Let's see. The closest person to the phone is Peter. What do we want to go? Papa Gino's?
Papa Gino's sounds good.
Yeah, they won the first race,
yeah,
so we'll go with them.
They were pretty quick.
What do we want?
This
is where the argument's going to start.
Yeah, I'm happy as long as it's not plain cheese. That's so boring. I don't like cheese.
I want a large pepperoni with extra cheese.
That's good. That works for me.
Is that okay with the crew back there?
I would think so. Let's see.
Is that okay with everybody back there? How about everybody else?
Oh, Megan's freaking out.
So if you want to make Megan freak out, call 272-8746.
Right.
It's like an added bonus.
Yeah.
We have a caller named Jeff. Oh,
Joe.
Right. Jeff?
Hi, Jeff. This is Jeff.
Hi, Jeff. This is Caroline in red. How you doing?
I'm doing good.
Great.
How was your holidays?
It was all right.
Are you enjoying vacation?
Yeah.
What have you been doing on vacation?
Well, I've just been hanging with my friends.
Okay, here's a question. What time do you normally get up for school?
6:20.
What time have you been getting up this week?
Like 10.
Oh, that's so great. See, I get up at that time normally, but when there's no school, like I said, I have to go in earlier.
I wake up around 3. Go to bed around 2. Is that how you spell your name, Jeff?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
The lady asked me, or the girl, whatever.
So, did you get anything cool for the holidays?
Yeah, actually, I got a cell phone.
A cell phone?
Yeah.
So people can call you at your cell?
Yeah.
What's your cell number?
I don't think I'm giving that information out.
Yeah, that might be a good idea. We have...
I don't want the phone number. I bet the cell he's in.
What?
Oh, wait. Is this a cell phone to your cell?
Phone.
Or is a cell phone...
Not a phone in his cell. A cell phone. Like a cellular phone.
Okay. Oh, cellular phone.
Yeah.
Jeff, you gotta be a little more clear.
Sorry about that.
Uh-huh. Anyways, we have prizes.
Really sad because I wanted to see the pizza races.
What?
I wanted to see the pizza races.
Yeah, I'm really sad about that too, Jeff. Will you yell at Corey with me later?
Sure.
All right, thanks. I feel better. Someone on my side.
So, Jeff.
Yeah?
Do you want to try to win something?
Sure.
All right.
Okay, what do you want? Which one?
Well, I'm really mad because I was liking that whoopee cushion.
Well, we're sorry, but Afia won the whoopee cushion.
Yeah.
Okay.
The sounds of flatulence are hers.
Hey.
What?
All right. So are we going for the something out of the wacky box, Jeff, or are we going for the Starbucks gift certificates?
Well, I'm not much of a fan of coffee or Starbucks, so I think I'll just go something with the box, wacky box.
All right, that sounds good.
So you want a question?
Sure.
Okay. Mm-hmm, let me think. Mm-hmm. Hold on, I'm going to... Where's that keyboard? What? Hold on.
Well, what subject should we do here?
We done geography yet?
No.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no, we did kind of.
Yeah.
Yeah, kind of, with the capitals.
Did we do movies?
No, we haven't done movies.
Oh, wait, we did Harry Potter. That's a movie.
Okay, I was thinking that was a
something totally random. Name?
Music.
Music?
Yeah. Do music.
Yeah.
Music, okay.
See, Jeff agrees.
Okay, Jeff.
Yeah?
Let's see. Name all 4 members of the Beatles.
The Beatles. All right.
Who's on the TV guide?
Yeah.
One of our camera guys knows.
Ringo Starr.
Hey, can we have some sound effect music here? He's got a time limit.
Harrison.
Was that 2?
John Lennon. And...
Is he getting help? I hear people in the background.
Paul McCartney.
Did you get all 4 of them?
No.
Yes, he did.
Thank you, Don Pardo.
Okay.
Okay, what does he win?
Oh, let's see. Jeff, you have won this fabulous Etch-a-Sketch pen.
All right.
Oh, can I see that? me see it. I want to hold it.
Well, at least you drink it every time.
I'm sorry, Jeff, but the Etch-a-Sketch pen is broken, so you have to get something else.
All right.
Give me that back. No, it's fine. You can have that.
No!
I want to see that dog again.
Oh, Shag went home.
Shag went home. He's in the doghouse.
We'll have him visit next time.
Okay.
Believe me, I'll make sure.
All right.
Congratulations, Jeff. Good job.
Thank you.
Oh, Jeff, before you go, do you have a New Year's resolution?
Well, I don't really know, but I just want to lay back this year, not stress, just, you know, wing it.
Sounds good.
Just hang out with friends.
That sounds like a good resolution.
Just kind of relax, take it easy, kind of a zen-like thing, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
All right. Well, thank you very much for calling, Jeff.
Oh, thank you for letting me call. Have a good day.
You too.
Happy New Year, Jeff.
And Happy New Year.
Well, he seems like a nice kid.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah.
So he's going to help me yell at Corey for not having the pizza show.
Yeah, he needs a good yelling at.
But we are getting pizza, so. Well,
good.
I think we should skip to another PSA now.
Sounds like a good idea to me.
Do you know who I am? Am I a P or a D? A Q, perhaps? Or a B? I am dyslexia, and millions of kids struggle with me every time they read. Call now to help your child manage his learning disability. There's no reason to be held back.
All right, we're back. Sock always takes a few minutes longer. There he is. Yes, you can come out of your shell. Thanks.
Oh, thanks.
What did you call up on Shag?
What? Oh, yeah. I think I got a hairball. But I'm better now. He's a good dog.
He's a very sweet dog.
Yeah.
We'll definitely have to have him visit again next show.
That's true. Maybe I could train him or something to do tricks on the show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
One of the things I got here at BCAT, by the way, is a lost pet page. If your pet gets lost like Shag did, you can have him put on the bulletin board, and that'll help people to find him.
That's right.
What?
Is that the bulletin board that has Corey's dog?
Well, yeah, but he's not lost.
Yeah, that's right. Rocky,
he's a poster child.
We know where Rocky is.
He'd better be at home.
We hope so.
And Shag better be at home, too, instead of chasing automobiles.
Those two would get along great. They're both very small and long-haired.
Like 90% fur?
Yeah.
Pretty much. If a wind blew, they'd blow away.
You kind of wonder if they ever got shaved. Not that I would ever want that to happen, but if they ever got shaved, would there be anything there?
No. Well, there'd be a chihuahua and a pile of red fur.
This is true.
I think, remember that monster on the Bugs Bunny show? Hey, crew. Hey, audio person. Get back in here. I'm so glad we put that camera in there. You know what? Hey, can anybody hear us at home? Testing. One,
we
two,
hope.
Three. Testing. Testing. Megan, get back in your chair. Is she back there?
Megan's having technical difficulties. Aren't you, Megan?
Well, she can probably do audio from the other side of the room. She's that good.
Yeah. Hey, that takes talent.
Let's see.
So anyways, do you have any winter plans?
Winter plans?
Hmm.
I don't know. I'm thinking the islands.
The islands, huh?
Yeah.
I'm going in the opposite direction. Snow.
Really?
Definitely planning on something like skiing or definitely like those blades. They're like short skis.
Like, what are they, rollerblades for snow?
No, they're skis.
That's
but
called
they're,
ice skates.
They're skis, but they're short so that no crossing and all this confusion where they get all fumbled up. That's my problem.
Oh, yeah.
And then maybe I'll try teleboarding.
Teleboarding? Is that like when you go skiing with a Teletubby?
No. No. see what you've done.
You need to
stop that. Now, teleboarding. Teleboarding. I've never actually done it before.
What is it?
Trying it new. It's like one ski, but your feet are like in line, and your heels are not connected. They're not attached. So, you know, Jesse could explain it, but I think he's too busy hassling with everyone back there. But he does it. He teleboards at Wachusett. Oh. Right, Jess?
Yeah, it's like single inline water skiing.
So
all the best aspects of snowboarding, skiing, and telemarketing.
It sounds like somebody lost one of their skis and they were desperate.
Well, it'll be fun. Of course.
Just like, what is it, snowboarding. That was just like, remember, like, kids, they'd stand up on their sleds and, like, try to stand up on their sleds?
Yeah, I liked that. The only thing I didn't like about snowboarding is I kept wanting to pick up my back foot. I'm not used to having them both attached to the same thing.
Oh, yeah. But
teleboarding, your heels come up so that you can actually kneel down.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I've never tried kneeling down as I went down a mountain. I mean, my knees have certainly bent as I fumbled, but...
You know, if you're heading towards a tree, you can say a quick prayer, like, oh, I don't want to get killed in a tree.
Yeah. I've had my own fall stories.
Oh, but, you know.
Well, I was going down...
Wait a minute, fall stories in the winter?
No, you know what I mean. I was skiing on, I think it was Sugarloaf, one of those. Anyways, I went up with a friend of mine that was a really good skier, and she's like, come on, we got to try this trail. It's really great. Don't worry, it's only like a blue square, and that's one of those intermediate, not beginner is green dot, I guess, and intermediates that blue square and black diamonds, of course, much harder. But So she's telling me, don't worry, you'll be fine. You can go on, you know, it's a blue square. So we get off the lift and we're starting to go down a trail,
it's
and all of a sudden
kind of on a corner.
She's telling me, oh wait, I think we just missed the trail for the blue square. Yeah, this is a black diamond. So of course, you know, bad words were said. And I
proceed, it was all downhill from there.
Oh, my goodness. It was all downhill and sky was there and snow was there. And
I see.
And I did this humongous somersault, and I landed with, like, a ski over there and a boot over there. It was this horrible mess.
I think I saw the scene in The Wizard of Oz.
Yeah, probably. Anyways, this big professional...
That's snow, you all over.
This big professional skier comes over to me. Oh, my goodness, are you okay? You know, I saw you fall. And he thought I, like, broke my neck. Apparently, it looked much more horrible than it was, but I had this huge scrape across my forehead from the ice and the, you know, like, friction.
You'll have to bring a photo in for the viewers next time.
I don't actually have one.
Oh, like, no.
Sorry.
Oh, come on, that's the coolest. Do you remember that video?
It was 9 years ago.
Wait a second, what was the name of that? The Thrill of Victory. Then they go, The Agony of Defeat, and this guy wipes out. That was remember that show?
No.
It was like The Wide World of Sports. And people, always began the show with that guy wiping out on the ski track, on the jump.
Oh, okay. I remember
that
now.
And people would just, tune into the beginning of the show, watch the guy wipe out, then they turn the channel because that's all they wanted to see.
Yeah, yeah.
It was like the wipeout show.
Right.
It's kind of like the $6 million man. It begins with the spaceship blowing up and stuff. We can't rebuild him. We have the technology. We have Play-Doh.
We spend $6 million
on
him.
We have Legos.
That's right.
$6 million, what is he made out of, rubber bands nowadays?
Right. But anyways, they're trying to tell me that I don't look 21 years old. Yes, I was 9 years old. It was 9 years ago and I was 12. I am 21 for all viewers who do not know me. I am 21.
Do you have your license with you?
Yeah, my license with me.
Okay, let's see it.
All right.
This is a test, you know, because when people take
picture
do the
me,
license,
Jesse.
They look horrible. If you have a good license picture.
I have a good license picture.
Oh,
I made him take it over. Look. See?
Wow.
I am 21. See this? We could even zoom in on it if anyone doesn't believe me. Oh, look, there's my MasterCard.
We're going to put cameras on you next time.
How's the glare there?
Why do you have two heads? Did you have the other one removed?
Better than one. But they do two pictures now. I think we have another PSA coming up.
Have it done over?
Do we?
What?
Let's go to that other PSA. I think we have another one, don't we?
We do?
I thought so.
No way.
Yep.
Yep.
All kids have trouble staying within the lines. After the third grade, it could be a sign of a learning disability. With the right help, most kids go on to do well in school. Call now to help your child manage his learning disability. There's no reason to be held back.
Hey, we're back.
Maybe.
And that was where the wacky adventures of our good friend, letter H. Where would we be without him?
Brought to you by, yeah. Well, we would certainly have a different word for hello.
Your last name would be Erda.
Yeah, it would. Oh, actually, we'd sound English when we say hello. It'd be like, hello.
Hello.
Right.
We'd all be English.
That'd be scary.
And what would that be? Tuh? And tat?
Right. Tat over tear?
Ouch.
Yeah. That would sound good.
H, we Anyways, love you.
Let's get to something
We're
more
so
interesting.
We're so happy and not happy.
Do you know what I'm excited about after the new year? I'm going to see
getting
the Bruins game.
I'm getting going a mark?
Will you be quiet? I'm going to see the Bruins play the Islanders. You know, they've been doing so awesome this season.
With, what's his name?
McLaren.
Yeah, and, Ralston or something like that.
Ralston.
And, Samsonov. Byron.
Garen. Batman and Robin. They're a great team.
Oh, and, what about, what's his name? Samsonov.
I said Samsonov. And
Did
Defoe.
You?
I have to say this, Byron Defoe, my
Samsonov.
Favorite.
Sounds like an appliance.
Byron Defoe, my absolute
Clean
favorite.
He's
the goalie. He's absolutely great.
Oh, yeah. If you'll, what kind of job is that?
You goalie?
I want you to stand here when we're going to shoot those big black
hey,
pucks at you.
He's done some great moves. Well, they're protected, you know.
That's
and
true.
I hear the Sox are doing good. The Red Sox, not Red Sock, S-O-C-K, but Sox, S-O-X.
Well, yeah, they've been sold.
Yeah.
People are always selling Red Sox. At least they don't get put in a laundromat.
And I guess, why don't we cover all bases? No pun intended.
Nice segue.
Right.
10 points.
So how?
Whenever we do a nice segue,
the Pats.
Keep track at home.
Who watches football? I haven't watched.
Hold
the
on, Clue. You watch football?
The Pats are in the play at home in the playoffs, but they're in first place in the East. And the Celtics, I believe,
they are in the
playoffs. Yeah. And the Celtics, I believe, are leading.
They dropped out. They're second place. They lost to the Suns by 2 points.
They lost to the Suns by 2 points.
That's
our floor director and director. They're just doing sports stuff.
Wow. Thanks, Jesse.
Now we have 3 sports shows on BCAT.
Yeah.
Woo-hoo. I can't take credit for all of that. I was getting information over my headset, too.
Oh, okay. Well, you take the initiative.
If you're smart enough to wear the headset, you deserve to get the thing right.
All right. So that's good. So I'm excited about that Bruins game. And I got my mom, for Christmas, I got her, with much hassle included, Jesse will tell you, I got her a Bruins shirt with Ray Bourque, his name on it, the 77 and the little captain C.
Did you get her an Avalanche shirt with Ray Bourque on it?
Now, did you see those stupid, I have to say this, I don't like those Bruins cross Avalanche shirts. They look so ugly. I mean,
what are you talking about?
Have you seen them? They're for Ray Bourque because he was a Bruin. And he was also on the Avalanche team. So they've got this cross. The colors look nasty together. And it looks horrible. I really don't like it.
And the Avalanche are retiring his number.
Yeah, well, the Bruins retired his number, too. So.
But the Avalanche are retiring his number?
He played with them for 2 years when he got the cup.
Oh, I guess he's responsible. He was on the, you know, all their championship teams, right?
Yeah.
Or most of them.
No.
How many do they have? They have 2? Hold on, am I going
to get up? I would have to ask my mom. She follows that better than
2.
I do.
Oh, 2. That's right. They've got 2 now.
Yeah.
Sorry. To all of our friends out in Colorado watching the show, well, get it.
Yeah.
What?
Well, we are coming to a close, actually. Are we? How much time do we have left?
A couple minutes,
I think.
Oh,
we've got a few minutes left. All right.
Yeah, we can probably take one more caller if you hurry. Speed
Quick.
Question.
Ring, ring. Just kidding.
We'll make it okay. Easy.
How many papers are on
the desk? Like all the other questions
desk?
Have been hard.
Right.
Let's see.
So,
we had a... They're called graphics, Peter. You put them up. People look at them and read them.
Put graphics up, not Megan's voice. But thank you, Megan. Wait. Was that Megan or Peter?
They sound awfully alike.
I am so sorry. Yeah, I am.
What a way to end the show. Good night, everybody.
Well, they thought that was funny anyway.
Okay, crew, before we go, camera guys, get a shot of each other.
Well, The voice sounded so sweet, you know. How would I think it was Peter?
Director, direct your camera people to get shots of each other. Whoa, did you see that?
Whoa.
That's Mike Bear. Say hi, Mike. Wave to everybody.
That's Mike.
And on the other camera.
Whoa.
That's
uh-oh.
Dan Farrell.
Dan.
Wave, Dan.
Hi, Dan.
And the crew's in the back room.
There's the crew. Hi, crew, again.
Okay. From all of us here at the Red Sox Show, have a great...
Absolutely wonderful
year.
New Year.
Happy holidays.
Yes.
And whatever you do in 2002, we hope it's really, 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 really...
Something. Special.
Something.
Have fun.
Okay, Megan,
and
get that CD
safe.
Ready. We're going to be leaving with the music of Death of a Salesman.
We're going to be leaving with the music of Death of a Salesman. So here we go.
Long after dark, 9 to 5 doomsday, 9 to 5 monotony. We have the street lamp blues under a starless sky. Can't stand this life we live, but we won't stand to die. Hunter's family, the factory block, wiping out iotas of creativity. Our intellects robbed, shaved down to nothing. And then, oh wait, I forgot my epiphany. So I got the street lamp blues. Methodical work, mechanical work, busy work like bees. We keep our minds off things important, debilitate us, please. Hunters ran through the factory block, wiping out iotas of creativity. Our intellects rob shaped down to nothing. And oh wait, I forgot my epiphany.